get her, Dag.
Oh, Father, guide and protect us, your humble.
I'm glad to see you're still. If you could part with it, healing powder would be welcome. We have enough stimpaks for now, but we can't rely on that small supply. Brock and Xander plants can be found throughout the valley, and you might even find some on White Legs you come across. There's an old saying that goes, if you want peace, get ready for war. You've got me figured half right. I'll shoot dead any White Leg that tries to creep into this camp. But it's only to protect the Sorrows. The Lord helps those who help themselves. But the Sorrows don't know how. Joshua and I do. Since I got them into this mess, I need to get them out. There is an important difference between killing in defense and waging war. Even a Gentile like you should know that. Joshua is a living Bible of all mankind's miseries of war. The debt he has levied through his actions, he repays every day. He is a monument both to God's unending forgiveness and to humanity's unfathomable capacity for cruelty. It's written on every inch of his body. When you look at him, do you only see a man of God? Beneath those bandages, he is burned flesh. As he burns, so does he consume everyone around him. Joshua wants to fight because the White Legs have stoked the naked flame inside of him. You see the light, but do not yet feel the heat. I can pray that you never will. But it isn't up to me, and it isn't up to God. It's up to Joshua. I should be able to address most common problems. What's the matter? Huh. You look fine to me. Physically, anyway. Until then.
I have seen many strange plants in the valley. Plants that seem to hunger for human flesh. Where they come from, I do not know. It is good to travel with another. I spend so long scouting on my own that I forget what human company is like. When Salt Upon Wounds took New Canaan, he ordered the White Lakes to salt the earth so nothing could grow again. What kind of monster could do that?
glad to see you're still with us. How can I help you? I appreciate it. Well, that's it. This is all we need. Now all that's left is to quietly pack up and try to get out of here without being noticed. That's assuming that Joshua won't try to stop me. And that he hasn't talked you into fighting the Whitelegs, despite what I've said. Don't worry, I don't hold it against you. You're an outsider. Fighting seems like the practical solution. I'll tell you again. There's more at stake. It may be. I hope it is. To tell the truth, if something goes wrong, more sorrows could die in the escape than in Joshua's proposed attack. Even knowing that, it's a risk I have to take. With your help and Joshua's, even if we're attacked, we can defend the sorrows and escape. We'll be traveling at night in small groups across the valley. With luck, the Whitelegs won't know what's happened until the next morning. But if the Whitelegs realize what's happened, Joshua and I will need you to help us escape. Don't hold back. I promise you, the Whitelegs won't. Once our path is clear, I'll give you everything you need to get back to the Mojave. But the Pine Creek Tunnel must be collapsed behind us. It's the only way to delay the Whitelegs' pursuit long enough for us to get a head start. Good luck, and may God be with us.
Daniel must have made it to the tunnel by now, but there are sorrows all over the valley. We have to help them and get Daniel out of here. Right.